guys, a very warm welcome to Rehan Online Academy, and here it is part 5 of our NTA UGC NET December 2019 CS paper 2 solution, right? And previous 20 questions we have solved in part 1, part 2, part 3 and part 4 respectively, and whose links are given in the description section. So guys, do watch them as well so that you can grasp the complete knowledge of the December 2019 CS paper 2. Now let's just get started with the next questions. So question number 21 is, which of the following class of IP addresses has the last address this, right? So one IP address is in front of us, that is 223.255.255.255, and we have asked that which class IP address is this, right? So you all know that the range 1 to 127, it is classified as class A IP addresses. From 128 to 191, it is categorized as class B. From 192 to 223, it is categorized as class C IP address. From 224 to 239, it is categorized as class D. And from 240 to 255, it is categorized as class E. So we have to match the first octet. Basically, to represent from 0 to 255, basically IP address is consisted of 32 bits. And these 32 bits are divided into 4 octets. This is first octet. This is second octet, this is third octet, this is fourth octet. So the first octet will let us know the value of its class. So, right, so we have to match this 223. So 223 is falling in the range of this one. So it is class C IP address. So option C is the correct answer. Hey guys, before solving the next questions, I am just requesting you to please like the videos and please comment your queries as well as your, if you have any kind of doubts, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel so that at least we can get response from you, because we are getting very slow response. And if you are really interested in getting such kind of lectures, then I will completely try 100 questions solutions for you, and I will also try to make previous years all papers for you, right? So I just need at least positive response from you for getting ahead of this kind of lectures, right? So let's just get started, and just show your positive response by subscribing our YouTube channel and pressing bell icon button and commenting on the videos and by interacting with us, right? So here is the next question. The full form of ICANN. So ICANN is basically, I stands for Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers. Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers, right? So basically it is an agency which assign names and numbers to different ports, that which, for example, HTTP, the port number is assigned to it is 80. So the class, right? So who assigned these numbers now? So here is a agency, that is Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers. So they will assign, right, like ASCII values of each and every character. So all this work of assigning names and number to port, ASCII numbers like that, ICANN is responsible for that, right? The next question is, PicoNet is a special unit of a Bluetooth system consisting of X number of master node and up to Y number of active slave node. So we need to answer it. So you all know that PicoNet is a unit for a Bluetooth system, so in which one master slave can be there, one master node can be there. So master node is the node to which different electronic devices may get connect. Suppose your digital smartphone can be connected to it, right? Your PC can be connected to it. So seven active slave nodes can be connected to one master node in a PicoNet, right? So option B is the right answer here. So you can also get a node, a special node for it, so that you can get it better. A PicoNet is an ad hoc network that links a wireless user group of devices using Bluetooth technology protocols. A PicoNet consists of two or more devices occupying the same physical channel. It allows one master device to interconnect with up to seven active slave devices. Means the devices which are connecting with the Bluetooth with this master node are called as slave devices, right? So at most seven active devices, at least at most seven active slave devices can be connected to single master node. So option B is the correct answer. The next question is, consider the following statements. The statement one is, fiber optic cable is much lighter than copper cable. Okay. Statement two is, fiber optic cable is not affected by power surges or electromagnetic interference. And statement three is, optical transmission is inherently bidirectional. Right. So we need to answer it that which of the following statement is true. So fiber optic is much lighter than copper cable, so it is true. And fiber optic cable is not affected by power surges or electromagnetic interference, it is also true. And optical transmission is inherently bidirectional, it is not true, it is some false, right? We can't say it, that it is inherently bidirectional, it is not inherently bidirectional. So only option 1 and 2 means A, option A is the correct answer for this, right? Option A is correct answer for this. The next question is, let P be the set of all people, let R be a bidirectional relation on P such that A, B is in R if A is a brother of B. Is R symmetric, transitive, an equivalence relation, a partial order relation? So P is a set of all people, let R be a binary relation. Binary relation means relation between two, means on A and B. So if A is brother of B, so is it symmetric? No, it is not symmetric, because if A is brother of B, then there is not necessity that B is also brother of A, because B might be sister of A. That is why we can't say that it R is symmetric. So first is no. After that, transitive. Transitive means if A is brother of B and B is brother of C, then they definitely A will be brother of C. So transitive, yeah, our relation is a transitive, yes. And equivalence relation, no. Equivalence relation, no. Why? Because for equivalence relation, it should be reflexive as well as symmetric as well as transitive. But we do not have symmetricity here, and as well as we do not have reflexivity here. That is why, because A can't be brother of itself, no. So it is also no. And the next one is a partial order relation. So it's also no. Why? Because for partial order relation, we should have reflexivity in the relation as well as antisymmetry as well as transitivity. We have transitivity, but we do not have reflexivity and antisymmetry. That is why no, yes, no, 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 yes, no, no means option C is the correct answer. And for better part, you can denote, you can just note the definition. Formally, a partial order is any binary relation that is reflexive, means each element is comparable to itself. Antisymmetric means no two different elements precede each other. And transitive means the start of chain of precedence relation must precede the end of the chain. Means if A is brother of B and B is brother of C, then A must be brother of C. If this relation holds true, then we can say that it is a transitive, right? And for equivalence relation, we must have reflexivity as well as symmetricity as well as transitivity. If all these three hold true, then we can say that this is equivalence. But here symmetricity is not true, that is why it is not a equivalence. And for partial order, antisymmetry is there on the place of symmetricity, but we already do not have reflexivity as well as antisymmetry in this. So option C is the correct answer for this, right? So guys, I hope the solutions for these five questions in this video are understood by you. And for previous 20 questions, please watch part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, whose link is given in the description section. And guys, please do show your response, because your response will show us to make the further questions or not, because it's the urgency for us. Because if you are really interested, then kindly interact with us so that we can at least know that you are really interested and we can go ahead with that, right? So guys, if you have any kind of doubts or queries as well, you can comment us and I'll try to solve them as early as possible. Thank you guys, have a very nice day, and Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.